The modern history of Bethany beyond the Jordan began in 1897 when a scholar from Jerusalem traveled to the ancient town of Madaba and accidentally happened upon a mosaic map from the 6th century, which had been covered under plaster for hundreds of years.
Here we have a map of the Middle East. We have the Mediterranean Sea, the sea coast, just west, and here, at the edge, we have the desert. The center of the map is Jerusalem. You see, west and east of the river, there are some inscriptions. The first one is Betabara. Since the 4th century, the place of the baptism of Jesus was known as Betabara. East of the river, we have another inscription, the spring, which is now Sapsaphas. And from literarian sources of the 6th century, we know that this name, Sapsaphas, was the name of Lavra, a Byzantine monastery, visited by pilgrims to commemorate the baptism of Jesus.
But why did the map use the name Bethabara instead of the original Bethany? The Christian tradition knew the place as Bethany until a church father came to the Holy Land seeking to identify the places named in the Bible.
About the 4th century, a church father named Origen was discussing where Jesus was baptized, and he was unaware of any Bethany beyond the Jordan. And so he found in some biblical manuscripts the name Bethabara, which he interpreted to mean house of preparation. This seemed to fit the baptism of Jesus. So he took this name Bethabara and continued to popularize the view that it wasn't Bethany beyond the Jordan, it was Bethabara.
Origen's understanding of the Hebrew word Bethabara was incorrect, since Bethabara means house of the crossing and refers to the place where the River Jordan miraculously parted as Joshua led the Israelites into the Promised Land. If Bethabara was in fact associated with a different biblical event, where was the baptism site supposed to be located?
The key phrase is Bethany beyond the Jordan. Beyond the Jordan is a phrase that would indicate it's not the Bethany of Jerusalem, but it's a different Bethany. It's a Bethany that is outside the land of Judea, beyond the Jordan. So that key biblical phrase, which is preserved in the best manuscripts, indicates that we should find Bethany to the east of the Jordan River rather than to the west side.
So in reality, the map was wrong. It read Bethabara and not Bethany, and placed it on the wrong side of the river. Yet it was accurate enough, when used together with ancient pilgrims' accounts, to lead explorers down to the area in 1899.
They read these two places near the river, so they went back to the pilgrims, following them, where could be located, and they found. They saw some ruins, but because of the war, such evidence, archaeological evidence, was completely forgotten.
Indeed, the Holy Land was shaken by two world wars and at least three major conflicts in 1948, 1967, and 1973.
Rebounding from their initial shock, the Israelis unleash a savage counterattack as one of history's most violent tank battles is joined.
As a natural boundary, the Jordan River area was subjected to endless upheaval. For much of the 20th century, archaeologists could not travel to the area where Bethany beyond the Jordan was suspected to be.